Surprisingly, if you put something like this isn't a sinusoidal input, but is a periodic input, the solution is periodic. It oscillates around in response to this. You can see I haven't quite actually run it long enough, because eventually, because the nature of this input is bounded, this response will stop grow. You see it's growing right now, the amplitude, but you can see eventually, if I kept going to 100 or something, it would stop growing. You'd get some sustained oscillation, okay? So the point is, I don't know if you're interested in this input, but you can create any input you want in this vector, and you can simulate to it as an alternative to doing all this, let's say, in Simulink. Okay. So we have about 10 minutes left. I'm gonna just briefly go over this thing again because it's really useful, and I fear it's not that easy to understand. Okay? We already went over this exact example, so I'm just reviewing it again in the last 10 minutes. Okay, so the idea here now, this is Simulink. We're in Simulink now. We have a model built in Simulink that we're gonna call Sys. It's just some generic name, okay? And what we wanna do is we wanna take this Sys. What is Sys? It's usually an MDL file, consists of a set of nonlinear differential equations. We want a set of linear differential equations, because everything we talked about starts with having a set of linear differential, and then we can find the transfer function, right? Once you find the transfer function, you can calculate the response. You'll be able to design controllers, blah, blah, blah. But you have to have the linearized model to begin with, okay? To linearize the model, you have to know the steady state, right? Because you always have to linearize about a steady state. So what this series of commands does is allows you to take a model, Simulink model called Sys, find the steady state, and then use that steady state to linearize the model. Okay? All right, so let's just review. These are not great. I mean, okay, they're fine. This opens up, so you could also just double click on it and open it up, but your choice. All right. So this is the real first command of meaning here. So this one takes, it's called trim. Okay, that's a classic term that comes from like aeronautical engineering for an equilibrium point of a something involving an airplane or something. So that's where the word comes from. But so you take whatever Sys is, you have to name it, right? I'll show you how. You have a guess for what the initial right? If you want to know what the steady state is of these nonlinear differential equations, you have to guess what you think the answer is, and you also have to specify the input. Okay? And then it comes back with what is the steady state for all the state variables, right? So if this is three differential equations, this will be a three-dimensional vector. It'll tell you the equilibrium steady state points for all those. It'll just spit the U back to you, okay? If you have a Y in your simulation, you remember when you did the bioreactor and you had two cell populations growing from a single substrate? That was your second homework, right, as I recall? That you had a particular Y, that Y was the ratio of one of those cells, so it'll give you the Y value that corresponds to these X's for your particular output. And then DX here will be the derivatives. These will be really small if it worked, right? Like 10 to the minus 11th or 12th or 13th, okay? So that'll find an equilibrium point for you, okay? And then once you find this equilibrium point, you can use these commands. This is not hard to understand. These are the kind of weird commands. First of all, you have a block diagram. You use this command to tell Simulink you want to linearize between point A and point B, and you have to tell it what point A is, like the input, and what point B is, the output, because it doesn't know without you telling it. So that's what this command, I'll show you how to use it, okay? Once you've specified these two points, so this will be a two-dimensional vector, I'll show you, then you can issue this command, and then it will spit back the linearized model, just kind of like it did over here. It'll spit back an A matrix, a B matrix, a C matrix, and a D matrix for your particular problem. That'll be the linearized model about the point that you've specified, okay? All right, so just so we can revisit this example, not go over the model much because we've done this ad nauseum, right? So this is a continuous bioreactor. There's cell mass, grams per liter equation. There's the substrate concentration. There's the growth function for how the cells grow as a function of the substrate you're providing. And these are parameters. So these are the growth parameters here. That's a yield parameter. That's the dilution rate inverse the residence time. This is the amount of substrate in the feed stream, okay? And so most of these commands are not exciting. This is useful, though, because I get tired of typing the word bioreactor stability, okay? So I should go back here. Actually, I'm gonna steal all this because I don't want to type anything. All right, so if we go back to here, okay, you see I have something called bioreactorstability.mdl. What I aspire to do is find the steady state for this model that's described in there, which is those equations I just showed you, and also to linearize the model about that point so I can use all the tools we've been talking about. So just so you understand, that's where the name bioreactor stability came from. It's an existing MDL file. I didn't just make it up. Okay. So I issue this command. I don't really want it to open that stuff. Yes, you can close. All right. So this command, just define this thing to be this, because I'd rather type that than that, because it's shorter. It's not essential. Okay. These just open it up, who cares? Okay, this finds the steady state using the command I just showed you. There's my initial guess, 1 and 1. I'm not specifying an input because it's specified in a particular function. Then it spits back this stuff. So if we, and then gives you the obligatory warning about step size that it always seems to do. So if we looked at the answer here, we'd see x1 is this steady state. So that's the amount of cells produced, okay? And then this is the amount of substrate. So it went from 20 grams per liter to about a half. So it's almost all consumed, which is good. It doesn't specify the input because we didn't specify it as an input because it's in the file. I'll explain that. Y1, I guess we don't have a Y1 for this. I'll have to check that out. Okay, and these are the derivatives. They're really small, right? Which is what you want because that means it solved the equation. You understand, when you do numerical work, you don't find the exact answer, you just find a certain tolerance. This says, I didn't find the derivatives exactly zero, but I found them really, really small. So if you were to find the steady state x1, since this solution is not exact, there might be some error in some digit, like the eighth digit over here or something, like you don't care, okay? So it's found a high level of accuracy. Okay. And once you've done that, then what you can do, this is the file I've created to do this. Hopefully you're getting familiar with this. This is how we write these files for MDL, right? So I've made an MDL file that includes this. It has these different cases. You remember this? This is the case where you evaluate the right hand of the equations. This is the case where you calculate the output. This is the case where you initialize, telling it how many state variables, inputs and outputs you have for that problem. And here's where you enter the number. Like if you want to linearize, I just found this number, right? You might say, well, how did you, this seems like a circular logic, right? You had this number in there and then you found it. This is all very suspicious. But it'll work. It doesn't matter what I specify this to be. You can run it, okay? I mean, like if you put minus 100 is probably a bad idea. You can pretty much put any numbers here. Doesn't matter. Because to find steady states doesn't matter on the initial condition, right? It's a steady state thing, not a dynamic thing. So once you found them, then you enter this so that when you subsequently do the linearization, it'll linearize about this point. It's going to linearize about whatever point you specify here, okay? And then there's these other cases we couldn't care about because they have to do with discrete time systems and stuff like that. Okay. So let me do this part first. So once we've specified the input and output points to do the linearization, which I'll talk about in a minute, and then we'll go, then you can enter this command. So to use this command linearize, you have to have a system, an MDL file. I've already defined that to be sys. Then you have to have these two points about which to do the linearization. Then you issue this command, and it gives you back the A, B, C, and D matrices, just like it did before. This is a 2x2 problem, right? So this is the A matrix. So there's the so this is the D. So this is what? The first equation was what? Dx, I think. So this is the dx prime dt equation. That's how it depends on x prime. That's how it depends on s prime. Okay, it's the same thing you would do by hand. So those are the partial derivatives evaluated at the steady state, just like you do by hand. It's a lot faster. That's the point, okay? There's the input, so that's how the dilution rate affects for this linear model, each of the state variables. For this particular problem, I've said that the output is just the first state variable. So this y thing is just 1 times x1 plus 0 times x2, because that's what I told it I wanted. And there's no d as usual. Okay. Once you get this thing, you know, you can find the eigenvalues, right? So you can issue this command. remember you have to do this dot A. It's created this lenses thing, but if you want to refer just to A, you got to use the dot A thing, convention that I showed you. So you can calculate the eigenvalues. You can take this thing you've created, create a transfer function. Once you have the transfer function, you can put poles in. So you can do everything, but you got to get this model first. So the last thing is, how do you find these linearization points? Okay. So to do this, you have to put together the model a little bit differently. That's totally wrong place to go. So if we open this guy up, okay. So you see, I'm not sure who it was. Remember last time someone taught me how to group these things together? I forget who that person was. They're probably not here. But so I put together the simulation. It looks conceptually like we have before, right? I have an input going through my M file here that simulates the bioreactor. I'm going to write the input to the workspace. I'm going to write the output to the workspace. But you can see it looks a little different because I've used these port things here. And these are required in order to do the linearization. So for the dilution rate, I put the input through this thing here. All this thing here is the only reason I put it here is so that I can tell MATLAB this is the input from which you're going to linearize. That's why I add that thing in there. Otherwise, you have to have these ports. It's the only way to do the linearization. So I'm saying this is the input point from which you're going to do the linearization. In other words, linearize with respect to the dilution rate, the input. And then this thing looks like this. The only reason I have this input port is because I need that because I have the other block has an output port and I need to connect them together. Okay, that's why I have an input port. But this output port is the same reason I put this here because I'm going to tell MATLAB that this is the output of which I'm going to do the linearization. So please, all I'm telling is please linearize the thing in between, the model right there. Okay, you might say, well, this is unnecessarily complicated, but obviously, this is a code. It's meant to be very general, so it allows you to linearize between any point. So, you know, you could have a feedback system and linearize between any two points. So it just makes it very general. It makes it maybe a little more complex to use. And in the remaining 29 seconds, I will show you, again, these commands here at the top that define these points. So you're saying the first point, so you're going to create a two-dimensional vector using this command I showed you, and you're just going to tell Simulink what's the input from which you want to linearize and which is the output. So the first thing is what model are we talking about in the first place? I assume you could call this sys, but I'm not sure. So bioreactor stability, which block are you talking about, right? I have one block called dilution, I have another block called bioreactor. So I'm saying please, for the input linearization point, use this model, use the block called dilution, use the port number 1, and call that the input point of linearization. For the output, use the same model, now use the block called bioreactor, use the port 1, and call that the output. So this defines the two points. And so all I've done here, and then I'm going to let you go, I promise, is I've identified that is the point of linearization because it was in the block called dilution rate, and then that is the output point of linearization. So obviously, if you're working on a problem of any complexity, you know, the methods we have about doing this all by hand is a little bit of work. So this will allow you to do it. This will linearize an arbitrarily complex model. You could have like 25 differential equations if you want. All right? Okay, so I will not see you Tuesday, but I will see you Thursday.